today's session. Okay, it's like an introduction to a data cap. Okay, it's a demo. Okay, what we are going through with the data cap, we will explain to you. Okay, so do you have any knowledge on data cap before, or freshly you want to learn the data cap?
I used to work with Finite Capture before. It's been 10 years back. Since I used to, at the time, I used to be the FileNet admin. It was version 4.6 and got upgraded to 7.0. And it was like in 2009, 2010. And then I moved to .NET. Now I got IBM Data Cap, and they're upgrading FileNet too. So I thought this is the best time I can refresh myself with the new concepts they have. That's what I'm here.
Understood. Yeah, you are very much familiar with the content management, it seems. Okay. So, yeah, IBM Data Cap. Okay, IBM Data Cap is introduced on 1988. Okay, I don't want to go dig into the histories. Okay. So, it is initially with the Data Cap, but later on, 2010, IBM is acquired. So from there on, IBM started adding more and more features on every version. Initially, it starts with 8.0 version. Current version is running with the 9.1.9. Okay. So for what exactly IBM DataCap will do is, okay, IBM DataCap is a document capture. Okay. Currently, it helps you to streamline the capture, recognition, classification of your business requirements and extract the important information from the documents. Actually, what it do, very simple terms, okay? Very simple terms, what it will do, it will, first we need, in this digital process, what we will do, we will do the scanning, okay? We'll do the scanning, and that means we will import the documents in different channels, like a scanners or emails, or file folders, that means NAS folders, okay, etc. Okay, so not only different channels, we can scan the documents, we'll get the document to the data cap. Afterwards, we will enhance the document, we'll convert the document. Maybe it's a PDF, a Word, anything, any document also, we will convert into a TIFF document. And TIFF document is a main document where most classification and extraction will work with a certain DPA. Okay, so we will do the conversion, and we'll do the image enhancement, like images tilting or image having some noise or something. So we will do the enhancement, and we simply next will do the classification. The major thing what IBM DataCap will do is classification. Classification having a different algorithms. So using that, we will do the classification. So once the classification is done, using different methods, we will do the extraction, and we'll get the important information from the document. Once you got the information from the document, you want to show to the user, means we will give a screen to the user. He can see the screen, and he can do some operation, like anything wrong or something. He can add himself there in the UI. And once he is done, then we can export to FileNet, any other repository, like any other web service or anything we can do. Okay, this is the high level flow, what exactly DataCap will do. Okay, so coming back to now, what we are going to cover in this training. Okay, so in this training, what we are going to cover is, we will tell what exactly DataCap introduction, what exactly there in the DataCap and other capturing solutions, and what is there in the DataCap and all in the introduction. Okay, next, DataCap architecture, how DataCap will distributedly work, and how flexible it is along with the support. It has a different components, how it is integrated with the different components, we will explain. And we'll explain the DataCap DCO, like the structure of the documents, how we can align and process, and DataCap workflow, the different tasks, how we will run sequentially, and how we will create and manage with the authentications. Okay, those things we will explain in this. And we will tell about data gap scanning channels, how different types of channels we can use, and we'll get the document from the different channels to the data gap. And once this is done, then we will go for the image conversions, like how we can convert the image like PDF or Word or Outlook, our emails or anything. So image conversion, different image conversions, what data gap will support, those things we'll explain. Once that is done, then we will go to the image enhancement. The image enhancement is like enhancing the image, which is having a noise or tilting or something clockwise or anti-clockwise, it is scanned, and you want to make it a proper way of emails and do the remaining operation. And next thing is classification methods, which is different. What are the different types of classification methods we have on the data cap? So those things we will explain in deep, so that you can understand where and all, what and all we can use. We will go very in deep, so it won't be any problem for you in the future in the projects where you are going to use any of the ECM project for the data cap. Because I work with the different banks so far with the very high volumes, so I will add my experience here, and I will explain you very much clean and clear with the real-time problems. Okay, so next we will go for the extraction method, how we will extract the certain information from the document. Okay, between different methods of data cap, those things we will explain here. The task rest conditions, like in the workflow we have our different tasks, right? So those tasks are how we can manage the task rest conditions, we will explain. Okay, and data cap verify is the verify screen to user, like you can verify the document and what and all the information is extracted. If you want to train the document to our data cap system, how we can train it, those things and all we will explain in the verify. Okay, data cap verify channel. Okay, next thing is data cap export. So data cap export, how current out of the box actions will support to export the documents to FileNet or any other repositories like a SharePoint or something. Okay, everything we will explain in the export. And not only on the part like we are exporting to the out of the box, we will tell that how we can integrate with the different web services if you want to add on. Okay, and next we will go in deep with the TM web along with the ICM configurations. Okay, so initially starts with 8.0, 8.1, okay, 9.0. Initially it is with the TMWeb.net. So it's a TMWeb.net, and later on ICN came into the picture. So here and all ICN, I think you are very much familiar because you already work with the FileNet version, right? That version you told, okay. So FileNet, you have experience. So you already have much familiar with ICN. So I'll just explain you that ICN configuration, how we can manage with the data cap. If you want to do a customization in ICM, you want to do the operations like how you done in the FileNet. A similar way you can do here also. Okay, it won't be any problem. They will give one own plugin that you can make use of it. Okay, next, data gap authentications. What are the different types of data gap authentications we are going to use in the data gap applications in real terms of like a big banks, how they are managing this authentications and all, I will explain in a very clear way. Okay. Next is data gap sample customizations. Instead of out of the box actions, if you want to use your own functionality to data gap, then how you need to write it in the .NET, that I will explain you, and how you need to integrate with the data gap also I will explain, and the debugging process also I will explain. Okay. So next, data gap role runner, we will dig deep into the data gap role runner, how the threading is happening inside of it, and how the sequential queuing and the different types of things inside the role runner, how we can manage the threads and how we can manage the logs And everything we will explain in the DataGap Roadrunner, how we can integrate with the Taskmaster server. In deep, we will go over the DataGap Roadrunner component so that you can understand better for the Roadrunner, how you can make use of it in the production environments. Okay. Next, we'll go for the DataGap distributed setup. Here, I will explain how we can do the distributed setup in the DataGap applications, how we can manage the load with the round robin algorithm, what you are using by the DataGap. Okay. Next, I will explain the DataGap maintenance in any application. Okay, it should have a maintenance. We can't hold the load for a long. So you have to clean the things whatever you have done in the long. You can't hold for a long for anything, right? So inside the system. So the cleaning process, how we can do in the DataGap is nothing but a maintenance. That also I will explain in detail. That's what we can discuss in these sessions. Every topic will go very in deep. We'll go in the real terms and we'll go in the real environment of how exactly it is happening. Everything will relate to that so that you will better understand. Once these sessions you done, you can do your own application without any doubt. That's what our aim is to. If you want to add any topic on top of it also, feel free and you can add also. See, and while explaining these components, there are separate little component DataGap related components. DataGap related things will be there. Those things also will get covered. So while explaining one by one, so those things also will deep and will go inside. So that you will understand any better. That's what we are going to explain to you, Atul. You tell me now, you got idea about DataGap, right?
Hello?
Yeah, Atul, tell me, you got some idea right now?
Yeah, I got the idea about the course content, but Will I be doing anything, any projects?
See, projects means you have already with you DataGap means. Okay, so every day once we are done with the session. Okay, so once we are done with the session, I will tell you to do some activities. Okay, you want to do means you can do. Okay. So you just do it so that once you end with this session, you may done with your own application. Mine, sir, you may done with your own project, a little small project like a POC. Yeah. Once you are comfortable, then we can start the sessions. We'll go in deep. What exactly DataGap will do? What is there in the DataGap? How we are doing it at DataGap? How the DataGap out of the box applications will work? How in real times, in real banking and real big companies with heavy loads, how they are managing with the servers. And this is not like we are going like these topics. Okay. So it's advanced imaging capability, how DataGap is doing in the heavy loads, that is the matter. And the maintaining an application is a very, very big thing. It's not like a creating one application, leaving in the production. So what exactly real-time problems will come and heavy loads will come in, how you will manage and how DataGap is version to version is differing and version to version, how DataGap is upgrading DSL and how they are coming across with the PMS, what we have RISE. So those all things we will discuss. It's not like a simple thing, a simple course stuff we are going to teach here. We are teaching everything very in deep. So it's everything is related to real world, I mean real applications. So it won't be like something we are training. See, one thing I will tell you in the clear way, I'm not the one who will do the training. Okay, I'm the one who is leading on team actually in one bank. So it won't be the problem for you in future also that I can tell you. In parallelly, if you work with any projects also, if you face any issue, you can directly raise it in the class so that in initial 5-10 minutes, we can close it off.
Okay. So will there be case studies for real world projects?
Case studies means, okay, you make use of the ABT application. ABT is a very right good application for the IBM data cap what they have developed. Okay, those ABT application I will explain you parallelly, and I will create my own new application. And so what while we are doing one by one, at the end of doing this stuff, okay, you come to know that okay, I'm able to do this. Okay, mostly if in your organization, if they ask you to do some requirement, up to here we came means you are able to do the things from the data cap from your side. And the case studies, anyways, I'll for every session I told you, right, I will give you the things what you need to do in your system. Okay, so these things you do, you just do the practice, then you come to know that what are the problems will come, how exactly it is happening and all, I will explain. So that once we finish it off, then you can do your own application without asking me also. So that we don't put any dependency with ourselves. So you can do your own, and we will parallelly we will give the documentation. I mean, whatever we have discussed, I will share you the notes also. You don't need to bother about the notes, and you don't need to bother about the what IBM has have some documentation for the advanced image capabilities. No, those with the IBM notes, whatever they have, the product developers given those notes also we will provide to you, so that you can read through. So you come to know what exactly there inside.
So what's the difference in the instructor-led training and online? Means what would be will there be difference in contents or contents will remain the same? Only thing is that you have that you are interacting with the instructor.
Sorry?
So what's the difference your online training, self-paced training versus instructor-led training?
Okay, it's like, see, what we are explaining in this session, no? It's very layman terms, okay? Anyone can understand without knowing a data gap. I don't know anything about, suppose if somebody came, I don't know anything. I don't know .NET, I don't know nothing. Okay, that guy also come and ask me that, so I want to do some data gap training. Then also we can give the training. That much layman training we will give here. That is the one thing. And the instructor training means, so if IBM product developers, if I provide you the PDF, whatever they have given in the red books, if you directly read through also, you won't be able to understand the terms. So maybe you can, but real world, real problems, okay, they are saying some term means the term in real terms, I mean, in your project, how you make use of it that you don't know. So we will simplify everything, and we will do very simple training, very clear training, so that you can understand everything. Once you go back and read their content also, okay, this thing only there for 10 lines. He told in a single line that you can able to understand once you complete this training.
So what's the duration of the training?
Duration, it depends actually. I'm keeping the 40 hours, but if it is finished in 40 hours, then it's fine. If it's not finished in 40 hours, so we'll extend for some more hours, like next maybe 5-6 hours extra. It depends on the training, how we going in deep. So once we are done with that, then we are done. Okay, it's not like a limited thing, but we are for now we are putting for 40 hours. Let's see how much time it will take. So each and every topic while we are going, then it you are also coming with your cross questions, right? May extend.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay. Anything? Anything? Any questions? You are located in US, right?
Yes.
Okay, Atul, you just check with this Kasha training people so that if we go forward, means we can go forward. If you have any questions with the data cap or course content or anything, you can ask me now so that I'll tell you. You have anything in your mind to add something in this course topics also, we can add it. Not a worry.
Yep. Sure. Thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate your time.